This is Mission Control Houston. Welcome and thank you for joining us for today's edition of ISS Update this Friday, April 20th. And now for this week, a look back at this week aboard the International Space Station. On a Monday, Expedition 30 Commander Dan Burbank and Flight Engineers Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin conducted leak checks and other tests on Monday of the Russian Sokol launch and entry suits that they will wear for their departure from the International Space Station and return to Earth aboard the Soyuz TMA-22 spacecraft. The landing about 56 miles north-northeast of the remote town of Arkalik in Kazakhstan will wrap up Expedition 30 and is scheduled to take place on April 27th. Burbank also performed maintenance work on a pump in the outpost's water recovery system. Shkaplerov and Ivanishin cleaned fan screens in the Poisk and Rosviet modules. And with an eye toward the scheduled arrival of the SpaceX Dragon commercial cargo craft, flight engineers Don Pettit and Andre Kuipers spent most of the day rehearsing a rendezvous in Canada Arm 2 grapple procedures at the Cupola Robotics workstation. Dragon is slated to launch atop a Falcon 9 rocket on April 30th from Cape Canaveral Air Force Station, Florida, and the station crew is set to grapple and berth the supply ship on May 3rd. Dragon will be the first commercial cargo vehicle employed to deliver supplies to the complex. Also on Monday, Pettit and Kuipers worked with the Space Sound Experiment in the Japanese Kibo Laboratory. One of the pair created sound with a special instrument that was recorded with a video camera and an audio recorder. Flight engineer Oleg Kononenko took photographs of Earth as part of the Russian Uragan Earth Imaging Program, which is named for the Russian word for hurricane. Uragan is a ground and space-based system for predicting natural and man-made disasters. And on Tuesday, flight engineer Oleg Kononenko transferred trash and station discards to the ISS Progress 46 cargo craft for disposal to prepare for its hatch closure on Wednesday. Its departure set the stage for the arrival of the Progress 47 cargo craft that is now on its way to the International Space Station. Kononenko and flight engineer Anatoly Ivanishin had worked on the installation of a docking mechanism in the pier's docking compartment to prepare for Sunday's arrival of Progress 47. Also on Tuesday, flight engineer Anton Shkaplerov performed maintenance work on a cooler in the Soyuz TMA-22 spacecraft that brought him, Ivanishin, and Commander Dan Burbank to the station in November. The trio is scheduled to return to Earth April 27 aboard the Soyuz, landing about 56 miles north-northeast of the remote town of Arkalik in Kazakhstan and wrapping up Expedition 30. Burbank and flight engineer Andre Kuipers focused on unloading cargo from the Eduardo Amaldi. This is the automated transfer vehicle that docked to the aft end of this Vesta service module on March 28. It delivered 7.2 tons of food, fuel, and supplies to the orbiting complex. And on Tuesday, flight engineer Don Pettit participated in several biomedical experiments that measure the impacts of long-duration spaceflight on the human body. For the sprint experiment, Pettit worked with Kuipers to collect ultrasound readings of leg muscles to see how well high-intensity exercise minimizes the loss of muscle mass and bone density that typically occurs in a weightless environment. And also, Pettit and Burbank had worked with the integrated cardiovascular experiment, which measures the atrophy of the heart muscle. Investigators used the data from these tests to develop countermeasures to keep the crew healthy. Then on Wednesday, Commander Dan Burbank and flight engineers Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin continue to prepare for their departure and end their stay on April 27th. The first commercial cargo craft to visit the station was also set for launch on April 30th at 12:22 p.m. For its test flight, the SpaceX Dragon capsule will deliver food, experiment gear, and station hardware. After a series of demonstration maneuvers, it will rendezvous with the station to be grappled and berthed to the Harmony node. Flight engineers Don Pettit and Andre Kuipers are training for the arrival of the Dragon capsule. They worked in the cupola and used the Canada Arm 2 to retrieve Dragon and berth it. That was, again, on Wednesday. Finally, three new crew members were scheduled to arrive at the orbiting laboratory's Poisk mini-research module on May 17. Flight engineers Gennady Padaka, Joe Acaba, and Sergey Revin will dock in the Soyuz TMA-04M spacecraft and join Pettit, Kuipers, and Expedition 31 Commander Oleg Kononenko. Then on Thursday, the ISS Progress 46 cargo craft, loaded with trash and unneeded items, undocked from the pier's docking compartment on Thursday as the station flew 245 miles above southeast Russia. A series of separation burns moved the Progress a safe distance away from the station, where its thrusters will be fired for several days next week for a test of radar tracking capability by Russian ground sites. The Progress will be commanded to deorbit on April 28th for a destructive reentry into Earth's atmosphere over the Pacific Ocean. Also on Thursday, flight engineer Anatoly Ivanishin photographed the departing cargo craft through a window in the Zvezda service module to verify that no seals were missing or damaged on the docking interface of the Progress. To prepare then for the arrival of Progress 47, flight engineers Anton Shkaplerov and Oleg Kononenko spent a few hours on Thursday practicing with the TORU, the Russian telerobotically operated rendezvous system. The Progress is designed to dock automatically via the Kurs automated rendezvous system, but crews can use the TORU to take over the process if difficulties arise. Meanwhile, on Thursday, flight engineer Andrei Kuipers focused his attention on the CART experiment, providing blood and urine samples for later analysis back on Earth, as well as doing a few rebreathing exercises throughout the day. CART investigates the mechanisms of heart disease and looks at changes in blood pressure during the long-duration spaceflight. Then today, on Friday, it was a successful launch of the Progress 47 cargo craft from Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan. The new Progress 47, carrying food, supplies, oxygen, and fuel, now on its way to the International Space Station, lifted off on time at 7:50 a.m. this morning. The Progress 47 cargo craft is set to dock to the station this Sunday at 9:40 a.m. Central Time. We'll bring live coverage here on NASA television at 9 a.m. Central Time, 10 a.m. Eastern Time. Again, that cargo craft is set to dock to the International Space Station at 9:40 a.m. Central Time. Also on Friday, aboard the International Space Station, Commander Dan Burbank and flight engineers Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin prepared for their return to Earth. Burbank, Shkaplerov, and Ivanishin, who launched from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan aboard their Soyuz TMA-22 last November, are wrapping up their final week aboard the International Space Station as they prepare to return back to Earth on April 27th. The trio suited up into their Kentaver suits for a fit check, strapped themselves into their Soyuz TMA-22 spacecraft, and rehearsed descent drills for the return to Earth next week. Meanwhile, flight engineers Don Pettit and Andrei Kuipers practiced for the capture of the first commercial spacecraft, known as Dragon, to arrive at the International Space Station. The pair performed three grapple practice sessions using the station's Canada Arm 2 during today's dry run. SpaceX's Dragon is set to launch from NASA's Kennedy Space Center at the end of the month on April 30th. And also today, Station Commander Dan Burbank and Kuipers worked with the onboard ultrasound equipment performing vessel and cardiovascular scans. And flight engineers Anton Shkaplerov and Oleg Kononenko participated in onboard training conference to review docking procedures and in anticipation of the arrival of the new Progress 47, now on its way to the International Space Station, that is set to dock to the orbiting complex this weekend on Sunday at 9:40 a.m. Central Time. Again, live coverage will begin here on NASA television at 9 a.m. Central Time, 10 a.m. Eastern Time. And that's a wrap of this week in space aboard the International Space Station. This is Mission Control Houston.